which burlaps do we want to use for the first one?
I should be half strip.
With no time left in the season to prospect for a new site, Clayton and the CK prep team have taken over a project from his brother, Jason.
We got here to the Triceratops site. My brother did a little initial excavation and darn near found a tail right away. They're extremely rare. My brother's got a ranch to run. He doesn't have the time, so we're gonna take this project over and get it protected and into a lab. There's a good chance it wouldn't survive that freeze-thaw cycle this winter. What we have in this jacket here is the articulated tail, just a whole row of tail vertebrae. There's a few other odd bones in here, I think maybe a couple ribs. This is a big femur, and this here jacket is part of the hips.
But you never really know what you have in these jackets till you open them up in the lab and see what's in there.
This dinosaur, when he was alive, would have been possibly 25, 30 feet long, 6-7 foot skull, big critter.
It's only the second articulated Triceratops tail I've ever seen. When something's articulated, it means the bones are laying like they were in the animal's life. They're all still connected in exact shape in the spot that they should be on the body. It's like when the animal's alive.
So it's definitely a worthwhile project for our crew and our team, and it could be a good payday for us.
After his team removes and preps the fossils for sale, Clayton and his brother will split up the profits.
I've heard that the strongest way to make plaster is if instead of water, you use like cheap whiskey, and instead of burlap, you use denim jeans.
The big flip is always the scary part. We've put probably 5 or 6 layers on the top of this, and so this layer up on top is probably that thick, and now we want to get this layer just thick enough so when we make this flip, nothing gives. If we don't get enough of a layer under here, the dirt all falls out and the bones fall out, and that dinosaur is wasted. We do not want that to happen.
You guys ready for another bucket?
Team coming.
Yeah.
Well, Luke, I think our hole's deep enough. You want to guide me back, I'll back the trailer up.
Clayton and Luke are back to flip and load up 3 large jackets containing Triceratops fossils. His brother, a rancher and fellow dino hunter, found the bones at the end of the season. So they've cut a deal to wrap up this site before the winter freeze and split up the profits.
You know, having an articulated Triceratops tail is pretty rare. There should be some museums looking for something like that.
Yeah, come my way now.
I'm anxious to get these big jackets to the lab, get them unloaded hopefully safely.
Yeah, that's good.
If it turns out to be a good specimen and find a home for it, it'll help us get through the winter.
The 2,000-pound jacket containing the tail is too heavy to lift, and Clayton doesn't want to damage the bones.
Hopefully that rolls right onto the trailer, and I don't know, this machine's a little bit light for that big of a jacket too, so I'm a little nervous that I'm even gonna be able to get this done. The only way I can tell if it's going good is if it goes wrong.
We'll move that medium-sized one first, Luke, and then we'll go after the small one, and then we'll be ready to roll this one in.
Fire one ready.
Okay, you're good.
So I got my machine ready to shove this block over onto this trailer and hopefully be able to at least shove it forward far enough I can haul it out of here. It may come tumbling off and break. There's a high probability something will go wrong. Okay, I'm gonna ease forward and just see if that thing will slide down off there. I don't know what to tell you. If you see anything that might be going wrong, let me know.
Copy that, over.
Bad. Better than I thought. Now.
Push it on over?
Well, that's the plan. I'm wondering if I get a come-along hook to this side.
I can run that.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. If you take pressure off and I try to lift and roll, I'm gonna use the skid steer and pick it up as high as I can, and then we'll use the come-along to hopefully tip it on over.
Ready for liftoff.
Okay, go ahead and start cranking your come along. Hey, hold it, hold it.
I think I can just crank it on over now.
Nice. Man, I'm happy. Happy, happy.
Hopefully the bones in those jackets are gonna prep out nice, and we're gonna have some nice ones in there that we can make a sale on quick.
We took it out in big jackets, so I'm hopeful there's gonna be a few more bones in those jackets. We'll have to wait till we open those jackets and see what's in there. Looking good.
Just tell me when I'm clear, Nate. Right on, guys.
Precision.
Surgical precision.
Done.
That's what CK does best.
Tired of your teachers. There's a lot going on in there.
Yeah.
That's for sure. Anxious for Clayton to see it.
Hey, guys.
Hey, guys. What's happening?
What's happening with the dinosaur?
Well, it's changed a bit since you saw last. Not much of a tail in there anymore. But what is in there, I think, is special enough that you won't be that disappointed.
Show us what you've been doing.
All right.
Wow. That's not a tail.
So yeah, we don't have a tail.
Well, all of a sudden, we got a whole dinosaur here.
Yes, we do, yeah.
Wow. So this is what we thought was the tail. These are actually neck vertebrae. We shouldn't have it exposed enough to tell.
Yep.
This thing really changed from a tail to an articulated neck, ribs, scapula, and this is running right into the skull. There is way more in here than I thought.
Kind of confusing for a while when we first started. Chris is like, there's ribs, there's vertebrae. Katie, I think these are teeth.
Teeth in the jaw? So the maxilla, or is that a dentition?
You're seeing both. So that's the right maxilla. You can see some of the teeth coming down, and then articulated perfectly is the right denary. And then coming up would be the brow horn. Then going back, that's running all the way up the right squamosal.
It's like a 9-foot skull.
And look at how big it is. It's huge.
Just to the edge of the squamosal, we're over 9 feet. So from tip of the skull to tip of the tail, we're looking at about 27 feet long.
We couldn't have planned it to come out any better. It morphed into a lot more bones and a lot more of the skeleton, a lot more of the skull than we even dreamed we would have. It's really turned out to be crazy good.
What's the bone count? How many have you got so far?
Based on the three big jackets, we're probably gonna come close to 40 to 50% of this animal. We still got a lot more work to go.
This thing turned out way, way, way better than we could have ever imagined.
In the field, we only saw a little bit, couldn't really tell what it was, but we've learned lessons over the years. Take a big jacket, and this is when that really pays off.
I can't wait to tell my brother. He's gonna get crazy.
Jason's really gonna like it.
Yeah, from going to a tail to all of a sudden we have 50% of a dinosaur, that's crazy.
We had a decent season.
If we don't hit some bones out in here, I'm gonna get nervous.
We had some strikeouts.
Well, guys, it's time to call it. It wasn't for lack of trying.
Some of the sites we found just didn't pan out at all.
Not a bone to be had. Not looking very promising.
But we did collect quite a few dinosaurs.
Oh, it's a nose horn.
It's blue.
Nice. There's two skulls here. There's two skulls here.
50 feet from each other.
Wow.
This one here is definitely gonna be the most special one. This one just amazed us and turned out to be a very cool dinosaur. Really a good finale to our season.
Definitely not disappointing to end our season on this.
No way. What an awesome way to do
it. I'm very excited about it.
Yeah.
Wow, you guys killed it.